Over in the UK, British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak continues to rally Conservatives on the eve of the July 4 general election. Talking to party activists in New Hampshire, Sunak referred to England coming back from the brink of elimination in the Euro 2024, saying the race isn't over until the final whistle blows. Despite this, Bravado's latest polls show a record win for the opposition Labour Party.
We have 24 hours left. We do not surrender to Labour. We will fight for every vote. We will fight for our values, and we will fight for our vision of Britain.
The Labour leader also seeking to rally supporters ahead of the landmark election that looks set to end the 14 years of Conservative rule. Labour's final campaign push focused on fears that voters could stay at home, seeing the result as a foregone conclusion.
Every single vote has to be earned. We have to go out there and make the case. Change only happens if you vote for it. And imagine... And imagine a different future Friday morning, a Labour government elected in.
Turning now to the race for the White House, U.S. President Joe Biden vowing to stay in the 2024 presidential race. Sources say Biden called members of his campaign team Wednesday, telling them he was not stepping down as presidential candidate. He is also set to meet with Democratic governors to reassure them he is up to the job of being the party's standard bearer following his shaky debate performance. The White House also issuing the same message.
The president is clear-eyed and he is staying in the race. I don't have anything else beyond that. He's staying in the race. That is what the president is promised to do. That is what he wants to continue to work on the successes that he's had. His record is unprecedented record, and that is what the president is focused on, continuing to deliver for the American people. And he looks forward to doing that.
Progress in talks for a proposed ceasefire in Gaza. After weeks with little public diplomacy, mediators delivered a response from Hamas to a proposal that would include the release of hostages and a ceasefire in the enclave. The Mossad spy agency says Israel is now studying Hamas's response. Egypt, Qatar, and the United States have been trying for months to secure a truce and the release of 120 remaining hostages in Gaza. But their efforts have repeatedly failed. Hamas says any deal must end the war and bring a full Israeli withdrawal from Gaza. But for Israel, it will accept only temporary pauses in the fighting until Hamas is eradicated. Hurricane Beryl now moving northwest towards the Cayman Islands. The Category 4 storm turned over Jamaica on Wednesday after forging a destructive path across smaller Caribbean islands over the past couple of days. The death toll has risen to at least 9, but it is widely expected to rise as communications come back online. Beryl is packing maximum sustained winds of 225 kilometers per hour. It is expected to weaken slightly, but remain at near major hurricane strength as it moves to the Caymans.